I'm Power 5 meteorologist Ramesha Shade, interrupting your regular programming because we have a serious situation developing across parts of the area. And this is a very dangerous situation. This cell quickly pulsed up and we started to see that rotation. The worst of this storm, the area where the tornado would likely be, currently over the city of Burton. Severe weather will stick around through tonight. In fact, a brand new severe thunderstorm watch just issued a few seconds ago. Get outside if you can because we are really cranking up that heat, but the heat will help to fuel possibly some strong storms.
Severe storms moving into the northeast at this hour. ABC's Ariel Reshef tonight on the Tale of Two Countries.
Tonight, new severe storms threatening the Northeast.
More of the same today. More rain, more storms.
Thunderstorms stalling over the Philadelphia area.
Temperatures at this point still in the 60s and 70s. It is going to be partly cloudy out there, so you may get a rare glimpse of a NASA rocket. NASA has tried to launch this rocket several times. They failed last night. Well, all I have to say is here we go again. It looks like we've got another round of strong storms brewing and pulsing up once again out there ahead of a cold front. Just a beautiful afternoon. It's not just the sun, but it's the much cooler temps, refreshing out there, and also that lower humidity. High pressure kind of pushing off to the east, allowing this disturbance to roll in, but we've got very dry air in place. So as the rain tries to roll in, much of this not going to make it to the ground because the air is just too dry. Right over you in Ashland, this is pushing off to the northeast around 30 miles per hour. Mansfield getting some steady rain as well. And also, we've had some rumbles of thunder. Notice that lightning right around Ashland. I've got to give you the truth. We do have a pretty good shot for some rain. I think we will be soaked for parts of Thursday, unfortunately. But we're still going to have a great time. Looks like the weather could get a little rowdy on us once again this afternoon. Scattered storms, maybe some burst of heavy rain, strong wind gusts, but at least the cooler temps have already arrived. It's been an active last few days, but we've got more rowdy weather rolling through for the afternoon. In fact, that rain coming down across University Heights. I'll give you an update on our severe threat and when we finally will have some nice calm weather and cooler weather. I love it. The butter is great. The movies are great. Can't wait to see some big summer blockbusters. Oh, I've been waiting so long.
I'm still on Bruno Mars, Leave the Door Open. I'ma leave the door open. I'ma leave the door open. Thank you, Ramesha.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Ramesha. There you go.
Bring it home.
Yeah, that's it, Ramesha. That's it. Thank you for that. Thank you. See? Come on now.
You got me going, didn't
you? Got you going.
We got to get back to these storms. Not that bad of a day for some folks, but other folks had to deal with some strong and severe storms. So you are exactly right, Tracy. And tonight, we all want to stay alert because there still could be one or two cells that pulse up and become severe. At this point, no severe thunderstorms in our area, at least over land. We've got a few strong storms across Lake Erie, but certainly things have calmed down from earlier, so some good news. But still monitoring areas to the west, still under this severe thunderstorm watch. That includes you in Lorain County, Erie, Huron counties until 1 a.m. So far, the severe storms have remained just to your north and northwest. So good news so far, but a few models still showing that one or two of these storms may make it in as we go through the overnight hours. So we'll be monitoring that closely. But you can see the strong storms out across Lake Erie, and they are heading off to the north and east. Also, a few strong storms, one north of Painesville and Fairport Harbor. We've got another strong storm north of Conneaut out over Lake Erie, but they're moving away from us. They're tracking to the north and east, but we do have a marine warning out because these cells could produce a brief water spout, and also they could put down some 45, 50 mile per hour wind gusts and some small hail, and they're producing a lot of lightning and heavy rain as well. So not good news for any boaters out there. We've got more storms on the way. If you miss out tonight, you'll have a few chances on Monday. We do have a strong cold front headed our way tomorrow. And ahead of that front, a few storms could turn severe once again. I'm looking at around likely in the morning. We may get a break around lunchtime and then more strong, possibly severe storms developing for the afternoon. We finally kick all of this severe weather action out of here for Tuesday. Behind that front, much cooler, much drier air. But until then, we stay pretty warm, soupy, steamy out there. And we will keep that marginal to slight risk for severe storms in the forecast overnight and for Monday morning, Monday afternoon as well. Monday morning, we could have a strong, possibly severe storm pretty much anywhere. But for the afternoon tomorrow, I think the main threat will be our eastern spots, strong wind gusts, hail, Maybe an isolated tornado possible, but that threat remains fairly low. But of course, we're going to be tracking it closely for you. Outside of the storms today, we had tons of heat out there. In fact, up to 90 in Mansfield, upper 80s for Cleveland, Akron, Canton. So that heat and all of that humidity, that stickiness out there helped to fuel those storms that pulsed up during the early afternoon. A few of those did become severe, and we will have that threat sticking around. We've got those temperatures still warm and muggy tonight. Some spots still in the 80s. That just gives you an idea of just how warm it is, and we're going to remain that way until this front passes through. Pretty strong front, and notice more showers and storms out ahead of it. We've got to get through all of that before things start to calm down. So overnight, maybe one or two cells make it in. They could be strong to severe. I think some of it stays to our north, but for the morning drive, prepare for a few strong storms out there. Tomorrow afternoon, more strong storms are developing just ahead of the front. If you're over around Youngstown, Carrollton, New Philly, you'll have a better shot at some severe weather tomorrow afternoon. Then we kick it out of here by Monday night, Tuesday morning. Few lingering showers, but the threat for any severe weather will be long gone. So warm and muggy overnight, few strong storms possible. We'll climb to the low 80s tomorrow with more storms on the way, but we finally start to calm things down and cool off big time Tuesday. Highs only in the 60s, Tracy. Certainly not going to feel like summer then. Of course, remember, summer kicking off tonight, 11:32 p.m.
We have our own issues that we're dealing with here, Ramesha, in Northeast Ohio.
That's right. Strong storms brewing out there, Danita. These have developed quickly ahead of a strong cold front that will knock our temperatures down and bring some calmer weather. But until then, we've got the threat for severe weather. In fact, we've got a strong storm that is pulsed up right over Kirtland Hills and Chesterland. This one is not severe yet, but we could be talking about wind gusts around 50 miles per hour already. We've got very heavy rain and lightning that should reach you in Thompson around 1222, Clarendon around 1227, Trumbull by 1232, and Hartsgrove around 1236. So watch out for that one. Also, brand new severe thunderstorm warning. This just issued in the last few seconds. This is for the storm down around the Mansfield area. It's pushed actually just to the east of Mansfield now, so this one has become severe. I was telling you a few minutes ago we could have wind gusts near 50 miles per hour. Now we're thinking this is intensifying, and wind gusts could be around 60 miles per hour in this. Tons of lightning. That in and of itself is dangerous. Very heavy rain, but at this point, concerned about wind gusts that could be damaging, maybe knocking down additional trees and power lines for this one. And this is pushing off to the east around 30, 35 miles per hour, pushing into Perrysville right now, and it should reach you in Shreve shortly after 12:30. So if you are in the path of this, you need to be getting indoors, try to get to the lowest level, stay away from those outside walls, because this cell will likely have some damaging wind gusts, likely around 60 miles per hour. We've also been monitoring some broad rotation in a few of these. No tornado warnings just yet. That threat will be a little lower, but we can't rule it out. So stay alert for all hazards for this afternoon. Main threat will be between now and 4 p.m. Farther to the north, another strong storm developing just to the south of Sullivan. Seville, you're getting some heavy rain. We've had a couple of heavy downpours roll right over downtown Cleveland, and we've got more heavy rain right over you in Chardon and that potential for those 50-mile-per-hour wind gusts. Looking pretty good in Akron. We've got one heavy downpour just to the south of downtown Akron, but nothing severe now. But overall, be prepared for more storms this afternoon. Storm threat will end by this evening. I think by 5 o'clock, it's over. So if we can get through the next few hours, things will start to improve. Look for a few showers this evening, but the storm threat will be over, and then we'll finally start to dry things out by tomorrow. For today, though, 60 to 70% chance for scattered showers and storms. A few of those could be severe. Highest threat for severe weather this afternoon will be just to the south and east of Cleveland, down around Akron, Canton, Dover, New Philly. So we'll be watching that closely. And the timing will be between now and 4 p.m. for those damaging wind gusts. That's going to be the biggest threat, and some very heavy rain that could lead to flooding. Here's the culprit. Strong cold front sweeping through, and these cells are firing ahead of this front. So until we get this front through, we've still got that threat for severe storms, mainly between now and 4 p.m., and then we clear things out for tonight and tomorrow with much cooler temperatures. So good news there. We are going to be dealing with this threat for severe weather. I'll have much more coming up. For now, if you need to keep track of us while you're on the road, listen to the Power 5 Weather by tuning in to Cleveland Star 102 and 98.5 WNCX.